So in unit number one, we have discussed the how the list of operation the computer has to perform to execute the instruction. Like suppose if you want to execute the instruction, we have seen our previous diagram how the instruction would be executed. So the different things are required to know the processor so that the processor could be execute the instruction. What are the different things that the processor should know if to execute the instruction? There are a number of phases are there that the phases must be done while execute the instruction. Like first thing is that is operation, opcode. Operation means opcode. Like what kind of operation you want to perform. So addition, subtraction, these are the example of opcode. The second thing that we have discussed in unit number one and two, that is addressing mode. Different addressing mode we have seen, right? Like zero addressing, one addressing, two addressing. The same addition operation they can perform by using the zero address, by using a stack and queue, by using one address. Right, two addresses. By this way, the addressing mode required, what kind of addressing mode you are using for the operation. The another thing is registers. Different types of registers are required, like MAR, MBR, IR, all are different kinds of registers are there. Again, you have to store your data. So different registers are there involved. Again, IO module interface. You may submit your data to the program through the keyboard. So there is an involvement of input-output module. Then memory module interface. You may take a data, you may take a instruction or the operand through the memory. Right. Then we have seen the concept of that is the interrupt. Interrupt means what? If suppose if your instruction is executing and meanwhile, suppose the interrupt signal is generated from the printer. Like your program is executing instruction and at the same time you have given a command for to the printer for the to print out. So after the finishing all the printout, your printer must inform to your computer like your printout is over. So that time it send an interrupt signal to your computer so that if any instruction, even though any instruction is executing, but still the interrupt signal generated at the same time you could see your printout has done, your printout has completed. So what are the advantages of even interrupt we have discussed in unit number one and two. So here, as we have seen, there's operation, addressing mode, registers, all these things are defined by the instruction set. Like operation, addressing mode, register, it is defined by the instruction set. Similarly, input-output module interface, memory module interface, these are the things that are defined by the system bus and the interrupt. Is defined partially by the system bus and partially by the support the processor offers to the operating system. So system bus as well as operating system. So mainly these are the six terms, or we can say the functional requirement of the processor. So if any instruction you want to execute, these are the six things that is required. That is the opcode, address, registers, input, output, we have to consider, again, memory module and interrupt. So in unit number one and two, we have seen how instruction is executed. Now, we'll discuss the first topic, that is a micro operation. What is a micro operation? By the name only, you can easily understand. The operations are which are micro, tiny, right? that kind of operation we can say it is a micro operation. Okay, so in our previous diagram here, we have seen how there are number of operations are involved to execute an instruction. Like PC is holding an address, right? And from the respective address loaded into the IR, then that instruction, from as per the instruction, the meaning of one is a transfer data to the accumulator. So at 940, whatever data is there, that data is loaded into the accumulator, right? Then PC incremented by one. So here is 301, right? So in this way, here you will find there are multiple small instructions are there. Operations are there. But even though you have to perform only the addition of two number, but still you can find here there are multiple instructions are executed to do the operation of addition only. So what we can say, the micro operation means the tiny operation. So we know the computer execute a program, and to execute a program, there are majorly two steps. Like, we have to first paste the instruction and then execute the instruction. So we have seen the execution cycle. In execution cycle, first thing that we have to paste the instruction. After fetching an instruction, then you have to execute the instruction, and then you have to store the result. Then you have to check the interrupt cycle is there, interrupt is generated over there or not. Accordingly, the instruction executed. So even though there is one execution cycle, but there are number of steps, and each which involve a processor register. Obviously, from the first step only, the processor register involved, like PC program counter holding a address of instruction. Then PC loaded that instruction into the MAR, memory address register. So memory address register connected sender address to the memory. Then what the memory will do, the memory will put respective element to the MBR, memory buffer register, right? MBR, based on the MAR address. Now then MBR loaded data into the IR, instruction register. Then IR, whatever instruction is there, the processor execute the instruction. If in the instruction, to execute the instruction, a different operand required. So again, the MAR asked for the different operand, then loaded into the MBR. In this way, the processor to execute one instruction, here number of micro operation that we have to perform. So whatever the steps that I have discussed, like PC to MAR, MAR to MBR, the series of steps that involve, and even the every steps you will find there is a processor register. Like MAR is there, PC is there, IR is there. There is an involvement of processor register. So all these operations, like first PC to MAR, MAR to the memory, memory to MBR, MBR to IR. So all these small steps as called micro operation. So if execute the one instruction, there are number of steps, and each these combination of all steps, you can say it is a micro operation. And as we have seen, each step is doing a very little thing. Like PC loading address to the MAR, then as per the address, the data loaded into the MBR. So here, what we can say, each step, we are doing a very little thing. And each instruction made up of small instruction cycle, like a fetch cycle, execute cycle and interrupt cycle. Now here from this diagram you can understand the relationship among the various how the program is there. So in a program there is a multiple instruction required to execute each instruction. So each instruction executed during the instruction cycle made up of shorter subcycle. Like program is there, so one instruction PC is holding a one instruction. So for the one instruction, there is a one instruction cycle. So we have seen in one instruction cycle, there are number of steps are there, like a fetch, indirect, execute, and interrupt. Again, to fetch, there are multiple micro operations are there, right? Like first, the loaded, the PC is there, PC holding an address of instruction. Then the control signal generator read command, and that address, the PC address loaded into the address bus. Then address bus carry your data to the memory. Then memory, whatever the respective address is there, whatever data is there for the respective address location, that data loaded into the MBR. Then, again, the write signal generated and data loaded into the MBR to IR. So even in a page, there are multiple micro operations are there. So actually, what is the micro operations? Micro operation means like the instruction cycle, there are multiple steps are there, and each step is made of the multiple smaller subcycle. So this smaller subcycle, multiple cycle like page, interrupt, execute, interrupt, it is each subcycle is executed by the multiple micro operation. So this is one subcycle, this is the instruction cycle, page, indirect, execute, interrupt is a subcycle, and this each subcycle is made of micro operations. So these are the micro operations. These are the micro operations that you have to remember. So micro operations are functional or atomic operation, functional or atomic. And these micro operations are operations of the processor. Now we'll consider one simple example to understand these micro operations. So as we have seen, there are multiple cycles are there. So we'll consider the first cycle, that is a fetch cycle. So in the fetch cycle, the number of registers are involved. Like the first one is memory address register. So memory address register is connected to the address line of the system bus. As we have discussed earlier, the memory address register is connected with the address line. That address line is called a system bus or address bus. And it specifies the address in memory for a read or write operation. So MAR putted respective address on the address bus. The address bus is connected with the memory, right? And this address specifies to read a particular element or write a particular element on a memory. The second one is MBR, memory buffer register. So this memory address register is connected with the address bus, and memory buffer register is connected with the data bus. So memory buffer register is connected with a data bus. So it contains a value to be stored in a memory or last value read from the memory. So what kind of value you want to store? So that value put it onto the data bus. And that data bus carry your data from MBR to the IR. Instruction register. right? So MBR carry your data and MAR carry your address. PC, program counter. PC holder instruction of the next instruction to be page. Already many times we have discussed. PC holder address of next instruction. And after the execution of instruction, PC incremented by 1, right? The next one is the instruction register, IR. Hold the last instruction page. Instruction register holder, last instruction page. Right. So page sequence. So what kind of page sequence we have discussed? Like, we have seen how the PC is there, PC holding address, the same page sequence in unit number 1 also we have discussed, in unit number 2 we have discussed. Now again, in unit number 5, we are discussing the same sequence, how actually your processor executes the instruction. So at the beginning of page cycle, the address of next instruction to be executed in the program counter. So PC hold the address of instruction, and after executing the while executing an instruction, PC incremented by 1 to page the next instruction. So the PC hold the address of next instruction that the instruction will going to execute. So we'll see the diagram. Like here in this diagram, you could see. Here, PC is a holding address of an instruction. What is the instruction is here? Instruction is this 110100. So PC hold the instruction. PC is what? PC is program counter. So address is 110100. And the first step is to move the address into the memory address register. Right? Our first step is what? PC loaded this address into the MAR, memory address register. So the same address, 110100, 110100100. This address loaded into the MAR. And because this is the only register connected to the address line of system bus, so why actually only on MAR? Because this memory address register is connected with the address line of the system bus. There are different types of lines, address line, data line, but the MAR by the name depicts at A for address, so it is connected with the address bus. The second step is to bring in the instruction. Now, what is the second step? So loaded into the MAR, MAR is connected with the address bus, and the address bus is connected with the memory. So what the memory will do? Load your data into the MAR. So second step, the MAR hold the address. So that address, put it on address bus. And as soon as on address bus, there is the address, control unit issue a read command on the control bus. So we issue the read command from the control bus. Why the read command? Because to read address, whatever the address is given by the MAR, whatever the element is there, we have to read that element from the respective location. So that's why the read command is generated by the control unit. And the result appears on a data bus and is copied into memory buffer register. So now the MAR is there. So after doing this, a control unit generate a reader signal. So control unit generate a reader signal. So what we have to do? So whatever the element is there for this address, we have to read and load it into the MBR. So see here, this is not the instruction. PC and MAR both having the same instruction. See here, both having the same instruction. But what is this? This is the element which is on this respective location. So whatever the value is there, that value loaded onto the MBR, memory buffer register. So after this, what we will do, then the PC will incremented by one, right? Loaded into the MBR, then PC incremented by one. So this PC is 100 earlier, now it is 101. So PC incremented by one. So it is loaded into the MBR, then PC incremented by one. Now what will be the next instruction? The next step is, so whatever data on MBR that loaded into the IR, that data could be the instruction or any value. So that data loaded into the IR. So see here, this is the same data which is loaded into the IR. So you can easily understand how the instruction executed. So whatever we have discussed in unit one, the explanation is same for the micro operation. So to execute one instruction, here you could see how many micro operation would be required. Okay, did you understand this concept? Do I acknowledge? Do acknowledge in chat box, did you understand this concept? Okay, thank you. Okay, so whatever we have discussed here in the fetch sequence, the same thing we can understand by the notation. After third step, okay. So here what we have done, the first is PC, whatever the PC holding an instruction that is loaded into the MAR. So it is loaded here, PC MAR is same. Now this MAR address, it is connected with the address bus and it is connected with the memory. So this is a memory. Okay, so memory having, it is connected with the address bus. So the read signal is generated by the control unit. And for example, this is the address. So whatever the value is there, that value would be loaded into the MBR because MBR is connected with the data bus. So the address bus, a read signal is generated and whatever data is there, which is read and loaded into the MBR. So here, MAR, MBR, and PC value updated. Now, what is the next step? Next step is to load MBR into the IR because MBR, whatever the data is instruction register, that will be loaded into the ALU, arithmetic logic unit. That's why this memory buffer register is connected with the data bus. So, and the MBR load their data into the IR instruction register. And from the instruction register, the arithmetic logic unit will execute the instruction. Like here. Here we have seen. So for always from MBR to the IR, data loaded into the IR, data loaded into the IR. See here. So this is the IR. And this IR provides this data to the ALU, like 1940. This data is loaded into the ALU. ALU know what is the meaning of one. One means transfer data into the accumulator. And 940 is the address. So whatever the data at 940, that will be loaded into the accumulator. So here the accumulator data is loaded. The same thing that we have discussed here. Okay. So that's why whatever the data at location of MB, MAR, whatever address is there, so that data is loaded into MBR and same data loaded into the IR. That's why you could see here, 0001, 0001. So this data loaded into the IR. Okay. I hope you got the answer, Ritisha. Okay, so the whatever we have discussed in the PHA cycle, the same thing we could see the symbolically. In symbolic, we can easily understand whatever we have seen here in our previous diagram, the same thing we can represent by the symbol. So by symbolically, we can write this sequence of events, like the first one is PC. PC holding the address that loaded into the MAR, memory address register. So the read signal generated and whatever in a memory for the respective location, whatever element is there, whatever data is there, that will be loaded into the MBR. That will be loaded into the MBR. Okay, so MBR, now MBR having that data. Then your PC incremented by one, and then whatever data is there at MBR, that will be loaded into the IR. That will be loaded into the IR. So in this way, we have seen in diagram, the same thing you could see the symbolically. But here, like PC plus one, but it is not the case always. This PC plus one, you will find it instead of this one, it can be I. Why? It could be I, because it is not the case always your PC is incremented by one. It depends upon the instruction. For example, there is an instruction, it's like a jump. So this kind of jump instruction is that what the instruction would be incremented as per this instruction. Always it is not incremented by one. In that case, it will not execute the next instruction. The control jump from one instruction to the another instruction, right? So that's why instead of this one, it could be the I. Okay. Now what is the T1, T2, T3? This T1, T2, T3 represents the successive time unit. So in the first time unit, at T1, what we are doing, we are moving the contents of PC to the MAR. At time T2, we move the contents of memory location specified by the MAR. So whatever the memory location specified by the MAR, to the MBR, then that whatever data is there in the memory for the respective location, that will be loaded into the MBR. And the third time unit, at the same time PC, we have incremented by one. And in third time unit, we are moving a contents of MBR to IR. So whatever contents are there, that we are moving into the IR instruction register. So in instruction register, whatever the content is there, that will be executed by the ALU. So here, the second and third micro operation both take place during the second time. So these are the two micro operations, and both this time micro operations are take place at time T2. And the third micro operation could have been grouped with the four, like here, this, both the operations are grouped together. Similarly, there is another thing, another way we can paste the instruction. Here at time T3, at third micro operation, we have incremented the PC by one or I. and the data loaded from MBR to IR. So here, it may change. Like this way also, you can paste the instruction. This is also right. And this is also right. Both the way, actually, we can execute the instruction. But there are some rules are there. While grouping up this micro operation, we have to follow some rule. What are the rules? So these are the rules that we have to apply while grouping this micro operation cycle. Like the first rule is the proper sequence of event must be followed. Obviously, we have to follow the proper sequence. What is the first sequence? What is the first step? That PC hold the address. This is the first step, na? So always we have to follow this sequence. Like PC is holding address, and that address loaded into the MAR, read signal generated, and whatever data at the respective location in the memory, that data loaded into the MBR, MBR to the IR. This is the proper sequence to execute any instruction. These are the different micro operations we have to execute. And that time we have to follow this proper sequence. This is the first rule, basic rule, obviously, that we have to follow. The second one is conflict must be avoided. Conflict must be avoided because as we have seen, there are multiple micro operations are there. So the conflict should not occur. So there should be a proper sequence. So one should not attempt to read and write from the same register in one time unit. So one example of conflict. Like if you are reading as well as writing your data from the same register, what will happen? We don't know actually the result. The result is unpredicted. It is unpredictable. If the conflict is occur, because that is from the same register, you are reading a data as well as same register, you are writing a data. Like here, the memory, whatever the data is there in the memory for the respective location of that data loaded into the MBR. And what the MBR is doing, MBR loading data contained into the IR instruction register. And from the IR to the processor. So first cycle is what? Like memory is loaded data into the MBR. And in the second cycle, what you can do from MBR to the IR. So you should not collaborate both the micro operation in one cycle, like MBR and IR. You should not collaborate together. Because by this way, we cannot predict our result. So for example, the micro operations is memory to MBR and MBR to IR. But the thing is, it should not execute at the same time. Then final point that we have to discuss here in the rule, like PC is incremented by one. So always the execution of instruction, this PC either incremented by one or by I. So I is what if there is a jump instruction is there? Is Patil Chandrakant. Okay, should not happen again. To whom you are talking with? You are attending a lecture? Okay. So I'm writing your name on my notebook, but it should not happen again. Okay, so what we are discussing here, like MBR, you are putting your data from memory to MBR and MBR to the IR. But you should not do both the micro operation in one same cycle. By this way, we cannot predict our result. Now, again, after this or in between, we have to increment the PC program counter by one or I. I is for the jump. If there is a jump is there, that time it will not increment by one. It will be incremented as per the instruction. So that time to execute this one cycle, multiple micro operations require. So I hope all you could understand what are the micro operations. To execute one instruction, the multiple micro operation required. So we use ALU. For example, if in the instruction there is an addition instruction, so we use ALU to perform the respective operation as per the instruction. Okay. Now the indirect cycle. So what is the indirect cycle actually? So once the instruction is fetched, we have discussed how the instruction is fetched with the diagram, with the notation. So the next step is to fetch source operand. Okay, so instruction is fetched, like the add R1 5. This is, for example, this is the instruction. So what we have to do, we have to fetch the operand. What is the opcode? For example, add 5-2. So opcode is what? Operation add. And operand is what? 5 and 2. So the instruction is fetched, but we have to fetch the required operand, required value to execute that instruction. So the same annotation we are using, we are continue our example that we have seen. We reach up to the IR and ALU. So ALU execute the instruction. The instruction is addition. And for example, here we are using one address instruction format. One address instruction format, it means one address is there and one value is there. And by using one address instruction format, we are using direct and indirect addressing. Direct and indirect addressing, both are allowed. So if instruction specifies an indirect address, then an indirect cycle must proceed by the execute cycle. Now here, so instruction register, IR, hold the address, and that address for the operand. Address for the operand. So because that operand is in the memory, we have seen this. In the memory, for example, this is the data and this is the instruction register. These are the instructions. These are the instructions. Here is the data. So in the memory, there is a data somewhere. So what we require the address. So for example, here, IR provided address to the MAR. So as soon as the MAR received the address for the operand, the read signal generated by the control unit. And for example, the address is 2. The address is 2. The read signal generated, and whatever the operand is there, that operand loaded into the MBR, because MBR is connected with the data bus. And MBR carry your data to the memory. So whatever operand value is there, that value, it is in the memory that loaded into the MBR. So the MBR register holder address of operand. Then MBR putted the value to the IR. So this address is given, that is a 2, and this 2 is provided to the instruction register for the respective operation. So the address field of the instruction is transferred to the MAR. This is then used to page the address of operand. Finally, address field of the IR is updated from the MBR so that it now contains a direct rather than indirect address. And the IR is now the same state as if direct addressing had been used. Now the IR having like a value, that is a value. It is like a direct addressing from which you could take a value and perform the required operation. So this is the indirect cycle. For now, we have provided required operand to the ALU for the execution. So as we know, what happened if the instruction executed, the next step is what? We have to check the interrupt is there or not. We have to check for the interrupt. So if the interrupt is there, if the interrupt cycle is occurs, what we have to do, we have to perform these different steps. The first thing that we have to do, whatever the values hold by the different register, we have to copy that instruction into the memory. Because suppose this is the program. This is the program, for example. These are the different instructions in the program. And your ALU CPU is executing an instruction. Meanwhile, the interrupt is occur here. Interrupt is occurred here, and PC hold this instruction. Now interrupt is occurred here, what you have to do? First, you have to handle an interrupt. And after executing the interrupt instruction, then you have to switch on the same instruction. So what you have to do, you have to store this instruction address into the memory, so that after executing the interrupt instruction, it will take the memory address and continue the instruction execution in your program. Okay. So after execution is done, we check for the interrupt, and yes, interrupt is there. So PC, whatever the address hold, loaded into the MBR, and from MBR, that whatever the instruction is there, that instruction loaded into the memory. How and where it is loaded? For that purpose, we have to save that value at the respective location. So the MAR provide that location address, and for at that respective location, that instruction is stored. So MAR is providing an address, and MBR is providing a data, and for that respective location, the instruction stored. Okay. Then we handle the interrupt, and after that, that if it is completed, then so here like MBR put it whatever the instruction is there here in the actual respective location. And after the interrupt instructions executed, again we read that instruction from the memory, and the again will resume our execution. So actually these are the few instructions that we are considering major instruction. But actually in micro operation, there are maybe the additional micro instruction, micro operations are there to get the address and all. The one thing that we have to remember, two action may each to be a single micro operation. Then after the interrupt cycle, the next one is the execute the cycle. So in execute, what we will do, like instruction register, there is an address. In execute cycle, we have to fetch indirect and interrupt cycles. We have discussed earlier that will be executed, and each involves small fixed sequence of micro operation, and in each case the same micro operations are repeated each time around. Suppose our instruction is what? Add R1X. The direct instruction. So whatever at location X, that value we have to add with the register R1. So at R1, whatever value is there, and with at X, we have to add both the value. And after addition, we have to store our result at R1. This is a simple instruction. You can easily understand. Now we begin with the IR. We begin with the IR containing the add instruction. So IR, there is an add instruction. This is an add instruction. Huh? So IR is holding an add instruction. In the first step, the address portion of the IR loaded into the MAR. So IR address, that is, it is holding an add instruction, that is loaded into the MAR. Then the reference to memory location is read. So memory address register is holding an address, a read signal is generated, and as per the address, whatever the value is there that we have to read. So the finally, the contents of R1 and MBR, memory buffer register, are added here. So for the memory location at X, whatever value is there that is loaded into the MBR, then MBR plus R1, it is added. So at X location, if there is a 5 is there, so that 5 value is loaded into the MBR, MBR plus R1. For example, at R1, there is a 3. So 5 plus 3, 8. So R1, so this 8 value loaded into the R1. Okay. So in this way, actually, the execution cycle execute and the R1 hold the final result. How actually here R1 and MBR, here we have done this addition operation, but this thing that we have to remember, this addition operation done by the ALU, arithmetic logic unit. Okay, so what it means, this R1 and MBR is loaded into the ALU. So here we have explained this concept with the three micro operations, but actually additional micro operation may be required to extract the register reference from the IR and perhaps to stage the ALU input or output in some intermediate registers. So in short, the multiple micro operations required, even though we have considered only three operations, micro operations, but multiple micro operations may require to execute the add cycle. Okay, so tomorrow, not tomorrow, in the next lecture, I think on Friday, we'll discuss instruction cycle. Again, this is a part of this micro operation only. Okay, so time is over. If anyone have any question, you can ask me. If you could understand today's lecture, you can leave the session. But if you have a question, you can ask me through the chat box. Thank you.